Hello, students. Let's read the problem. And it says, what is the equation of the axis of symmetry in the function f of x equals negative 4x squared minus 20x plus 9? So we're looking for the axis of symmetry, right? And they're giving us a function already. So I don't know if you remember, but there's a formula that we can actually use for the axis of symmetry, right? And we have it right here, and it says x equals negative b over 2a. Okay, so my formula is asking me to find a and b. Well, a and b, I can get them from the equation that was given to me, but I need to write down my standard form for quadratics. Okay, so once I do that, then I can identify my a and b. So a will be negative 4. And b will be negative 20. So when I come back to my formula, I can replace those values now. So I have x equals negative b, it's a negative 20, then I write down negative 20. And on the denominator, I have a 2 times the a. A is equals to a negative 4. So let's write down negative 4 here. So I'm gonna get x equals. Now, remember that this negative outside is like multiplying everything by negative. So, negative times a negative, it's a positive. So, we get positive 20 over 2 times negative 4, it's negative 8. Now, remember that the negative on the denominator is the same thing as writing it as a negative of my whole number. Because remember that negative means positive 20 divided by a negative 8. So my answer actually becomes a negative answer. Okay? So what I'm gonna do next is I need to decide if I can simplify. Remember, simplify means can I find a number that divides both of them? And the answer is 4. I can divide both of them by 4. And when I do that, I get 20 divided by 4 is 5. Don't forget the negative sign. And 8 divided by 4 is 2. So I found the axis of symmetry. And the axis of symmetry, we always have x equals. Because remember, the axis of symmetry, it's your vertical line that is crossing up and down. So it crosses the x-axis, right? So that's going to be my answer. And that will be letter B for this one.